Can you get away shooting handheld, or should you be using a gimbal? So I picked up a gimbal recently, and personally I love it. I've been trying to use it for almost all the shots I've been doing, all the video I've been taking, but I was thinking, is it worth it? Should you save that money and put it on something else, you know, get Premiere or get Final Cut or get a different lens? Or is the gimbal something that you should actually invest your money into? So I made a couple little short films with a friend of mine today. They're going to kind of show the difference between handheld and gimbal. First one I'm going to show you is going to be with the gimbal, and then I'll show you the one handheld after that. One thing that's important to point out when shooting handheld, it's really, really hard to get low shots. The lower you go, you're not going to have good posture, you're going to be bending over, so you're going to be moving a lot. It's really hard to get a steady, stable shot handheld when you're shooting low. So keep that in mind when you watch the next one. Something I want to note as well for all the videos, all the video I shot was in 24 frames per second, no post stabilization, so I'm not using warp stabilizer in Premiere or anything like that. It's just the stabilization from the gimbal, or just the in-body stabilization from the camera. There's no post stabilization at all. Now all the shots you take handheld, you can do. Some cameras have good in-body stabilization. I'm shooting with a Sony A7ii. I have in-body stabilization, but you still get some movement. The gimbal just makes everything much more fluid, much more smooth, and if you're trying to get any sort of panning from over here, and you're trying to like pan around a subject, so much easier to get a smooth shot with a gimbal. Trying to do that handheld, you're going to be coming from over here, and you're going to be moving, and you're going to be situating your weight. It's going to be a little bit shaky. You're not going to get perfect. The heavier the camera, you do actually get a little bit steadier shot, but that kind of goes with the gimbal as well. The gimbal I'm using weighs a couple pounds. I don't know exactly how much, but it weighs a couple pounds, so that's going to force you to be holding it a little bit more steady as well. And then on top of it, just the gimbal itself is going to be balancing it. You really do get a better shot. But is it worth it? Well, it depends on what you're trying to do. If you're going to be doing a lot of stationary shots similar to this right here where you're not moving, you don't need it, just use a tripod. If you're going to be doing guitar playthroughs or drum playthroughs, where you're going to be setting it up in one stationary spot, filming the whole song, setting it up somewhere else, filming the whole song, you don't need it. But if you're going to be moving, especially if you're doing any sort of side-to-side movement, that's where you really notice the benefit the most, then yeah, I'd say it's definitely worth it. But it depends on what you're trying to do. For me personally, what I'm trying to do, it really helps. I really get a lot better fluid shot, a lot more stable shot. It makes a big difference. I bought my camera, I bought a 50mm lens, and then I bought the gimbal. And I think personally for me, that was the right approach. That was the right progression of things to get for my camera. But everybody's gonna be different. So is the gimbal worth it? Personally, I say yes, but it depends on what you're looking to do. They're going to be anywhere between $500 to $1,000. You want to get some really, really high quality ones, you can spend a couple grand. The average one though, like the Ronin or the Mosa Air, you're going to be around $500 to $700. But is it worth it? Personally, I say yes. It just depends on what you're looking to do. Hopefully the videos I made today can kind of help you make that decision if it is something that's suitable for you. But let me know what you think.